Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to today's video, guys. Today we're gonna be trying out the new ISO because it just got buffed. Now on stream I was saying the buffs ahead and I was actually wrong, so that's awkward. So if you were in the stream, sorry about that. The actual buffs that happened to the ISO, they were like hard for me to find, but I found them. I haven't pulled up right here. So it has reduced movement speed penalty for the drum mag, and it has increased base ADS movement speed. So I thought it had increased ADF speed, and so I put on the 50 round drum mag because I was like, if it increased the ADS speed, the 50 round drum mag would, you know, lowers your ADS speed and it obviously lowers your movement speed. But I was like, if they increase the base ADS speed, then this is good. So I used it all on stream all last night, and I thought, I mean, I guess it might have been placebo, I don't know, but I thought it was fine. Regardless though, the reduced movement speed penalty for the drum mag is still really awesome, and the increased base ADS movement speed is also awesome. There's not like a lot of, I feel like you don't do a lot of like walking and moving with this gun, because it's an SMG, you do like a lot of like snap shooting. However, any kind of buff is a buff, so it's not a crazy buff, but I always thought from the beginning that the ISO is a pretty good gun, and I know that it's not as good as the MP5. However, it's still like a very, very viable gun, and so with any buff is nice, and they didn't buff it to the point to where it is like broken. So we love to see that, and that's what we're gonna be using today. Speaking of the stream last night, we did give away the Edgar merch t-shirt, just like I mentioned in yesterday's video. Visions is the one who won, and I want to put a quick disclaimer in this video. I said it multiple times on the stream last night, just because I know like the world is a weird place, and I'm not trying to get in trouble for anything like that. You know, hashtag safe plays Rudy. Basically, I forgot to mute everyone. So basically, Visions is under 18 years old. So what we're doing is some point today or this weekend, I'm gonna be hopping into a Discord call with his parents, and then I'm gonna get the permission from them, and then I'm gonna get their name and their address to send the shirt to. So that way there's like no weird mumbo jumbo and all that nonsense. I wanted to throw that disclaimer in this video too, because I know that the world is weird and it's basically a witch hunt. So we're not having any of that. But that's besides the point. The stream was pretty awesome last night. It's so weird. So there was an update that came out. I'm not sure like when exactly it came out, but basically they said that like some of the maps, when they're in rotation for game modes, it would block other maps from appearing. And for Search and Destroy, that map was Rust. So they took out Rust because they're saying that when Rust is in the game, it blocks other maps. But last night on stream, we didn't hardly play that many different maps. Last night we played a lot of Piccadilly and a lot of Arklov Peak for the most part. All right, I got that guy. I like shooting people in the foot with this explosive tip crossbow. You guys see, this is called my disrespect class. I love this class. It's just making like Call of Duty like really fun right now, and I'm loving it. Like I don't feel like I have to get off. Like, so I'm enjoying playing Fall Guys, and we've actually been ending the streams with Fall Guys, but I don't feel like I have to. Like I'm actually just having fun playing Call of Duty. But what I was saying is, so we've been playing a lot of like Piccadilly and Arklov Peak, and we've been seeing Grasnar Raid, but if I'm gonna be honest with you, we kind of like dodge it when we can because it's a terrible map. But like we haven't seen Shoot House in like I think the last two streams. There's been no Shoot House. Yesterday we finally got Ramazza once after playing for 4 hours. Where is everyone? But we got Ramazza one time after playing 4 hours, no Shoot House. I mean, it's like weird stuff. I'm not sure what's going on, but I'm sure they'll fix it soon, I hope. So this weekend, my mother-in-law is coming over. Actually, today, she's coming over, and she's going to be staying for the weekend. It's going to be a lot of fun. But with that being said, I will not have a stream this weekend, except for Sunday night at 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. We should have a stream, because, and I'm telling you guys that now, because I don't have a video that goes up on Sundays ever. So that's why I was letting you guys know now that Sunday night, 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time should be the next stream. I'm like 99% sure of that. If you want to get like 100% up to date, you can follow me on Twitter, and or now we have the new Discord server that you're gonna, you know, if you join, that's where you can meet other people, and then also that's how you can like play on the streams and then all that fun stuff. Sorry, I was trying to get a crossbow kill, dude. I love this crossbow. Something pretty epic that happened today, so I'm recording this day of, so this is coming out today on Friday. Something that happened this morning. I was watching Dr. Lupo stream. He's streaming Fall Guys, you know, and like I said, Fall Guys, I mean, it's a fun game to watch, fun game to play. and he's streaming it, and I seen on Twitter that Fall Guys tweeted out, like, someone is, like, the fallen one, like, the chosen one. They're, like, statistically the best player in Fall Guys right now, so they're giving them, like, this legendary costume, like, one day early. And I'm sitting there watching Fall, or Dr. Lupo, and they tweeted out, Fall Guys tweeted out the number, because, like, when you're in stream mode, like, you don't actually see anyone's names, you just see, like, a random number they're assigned. And they tweeted out the number, and I looked over at Dr. Lupo's thing, and it was that number. And I was like, hold up, wait a minute. I tweeted at them both, and it turns out Dr. Lupo was the fallen one, which is so awesome. Like, I just happened to have clicked his stream. Normally, like, this time in the morning, I'm working, and I work from home, so I get to, like, listen to streams or podcasts or whatever, like, while I work. I mean, I could have done that, like, while I was in the office, too. But, you know what I'm saying. That's besides the point. I suck a guy. I'm a gamer. But so I normally listen to Tim the Tap Man at this point in the day. But he is moving. So I was listening to Dr. Lupo. And that was a pretty awesome moment. That guy, I heard you. I'm going to get this crossbow. Dude, that's another thing I like about the crossbow, especially in search, is you can, like, kind of pre-fire with. Like, you can throw the crossbow nade out there. Like, at a time like this, like, when I'm clearly in danger, I can just start, like, kind of throwing this. And it usually scares people away. And the best part about it is, like, losers like this with the right shield, I can, like, literally just stick them with the crossbow and they die. Oh no. Right here, just throw that out there and then reload back up. I mean, I don't usually get kills from it, but it usually backs them up enough. I just think it's funny, dude. If you ever watch any of my streams, you know I hate overkill. Actually, even my videos, I say it. I hate overkill, but there's that saying where you either die a hero or you live long enough to become the villain. And I'm feeling that right now for overkill specifically. Like, I'm so tired of overkill that at this point I'm just like, screw it, I'm using overkill myself, dude. Everyone uses overkill against me. It's some of the most annoying shenanigans ever. And I feel like at least if I'm using overkill, I can at least use the crossbow, which is not a good weapon. It's like a very, like a weird weapon to use. Like, when you're like, if you see someone using the crossbow, you can tell that they're clearly just like trolling and they're just going for some disrespect clips. And that's what I'm going for here. Dude, I wanted to know this going him so bad coming up the top. Oh, another update. So I said about this the other day. There's the Discord creates my class server or channel in the server right now, in the Rudy server. And I updated you guys about it the other day. So I was going to actually upload it for today. I was going to record it for today, upload it for today. But then the ISO got buffed and I wanted to make this video instead. Because, like, if I wait until Monday to make this video, then it'll be, like, way outdated, obviously. Like, this one's already kind of outdated. But, so, sometime next week, I am definitely going to be recording that video. I'm not sure if it's going to be, like, early in the week or later in the week. I'm not 100% sure. But I believe the class that is winning right now is 5x class. So, basically, if you want to go in there and vote, so go in there and look at all the classes that have been made. And then just leave an Edgar face reaction to the class that you want to win. Because the class with the most Edgar face reactions is the one I'm going to be using. And if you think you have an incredible idea, right now it's, like, there's already, like, a few people with, like, 7 votes in there, so it might be, like, late. What you might want to do is just, like, save your class for the next time, because as soon as I do the video, I'm going to delete all the messages in there, and we're going to go again. But, if you think you can beat 7 or 8 votes by, literally, like, sometime this week, no idea what day, then go for it. But, otherwise, you definitely want to get in there, and you want to just vote for the class. Got him. You definitely want to get in there and just vote for the class that you think is going to be the best, like, to watch, that I should try. The biggest challenge for me, and like I said, so right now 5x is winning, and his is a Dragunov class. I cannot believe I missed that shot. I choked. There we go. That time I got him. Is there another one here? I think so, right? Oh, there is. He's above me. Let's go Dead Silence up here and assassinate him. If I assassinated him, you have to like this video. No, I didn't assassinate him. You still have to like the video. I said if I meleeed him, you'd have to like the video. That's what I said. Hold on. Let me get this crossbow kill to make up for that mumbo jumbo. Here we go. Boop. Never mind. I said I'm gonna get an ISO kill to make up for that mumbo jumbo. Hold on. Here we go. This is it. This is our moment. No, never mind. I said that this is not our moment. Disregard all that. I have to call in this precision airstrike real quick before the game ends. Dang it. I really wanted to get that guy with the crossbow, but it is what it is. That was, wow, dude. We smoked this team. That was not even close at all. 250-83. Yikes. Oh my goodness, dude. Speaking of, like, hardpoint, tonight, like, today, I think by the time this video comes out, it'll already be done, but the Huntsmen are playing their playoff games. 28-18 finally went positive on the channel. It's been so long. But the Huntsmen are playing tonight, and I cannot wait to watch that. I'm pretty sure that by the time this video comes out, those matches are already be done. I'm not 100% sure. Here's the class setup on the ISO I was using today. I have the Revolution and the 50 round drum bag that are both attachments that lower your ADS speed. But I mean, as you guys were watching today, it felt like pretty quick. Now, if you wanted to, you could switch the 50 round mag back to the 30 round mag. It still lowers your aim down sight speed, but not as much. Or if you don't, I have this Revolution on because this is like equivalent to every other Call of Duty's long barrel attachment. If you don't have any intentions of going for like a medium range or long range shot, then you can go for the 140mm close quarter barrel. So that's the only thing you could really change. And then also, I mean, obviously the Nightshade in place of the Revolution if you're into that kind of stuff. But I don't like running silencers. I think that I don't want any more negatives. I like the where the guns are right now, like the speed and everything. And I feel like this Nightshade would just make it even slower, wouldn't it not? Because you're adding more weight. Not sure. That is going to do it for today's video, guys. Right now, our Discord server is 70 members deep, which is crazy. Like, for real crazy. Like, when we made the Discord server, I thought we'd get 10 to 20 people. It's, like, not even a week old yet, or it's close to a week old. And we're at 70 members right now? That is incredible. We're hoping to get to 100 sometime in September. That would be awesome. And also, guys, for those of you who like to play along, the secret message for today's video, if you don't know, at the end of all the video, sometimes I put it in the middle, sometimes I had multiple secret messages just so I can see who the real supporters are. I appreciate you, by the way. So if the secret message that you can either comment down below and or tweet it at me, whichever one you want, is going to be, let's make it ISO buffed. Yeah, ISO buffed. So ISO space buffed, because the ISO is buffed. Yeah, that's gonna have to be it. I know that's like pretty generic, but that is the phrase, so that way I know that you guys watch this video. Thank you guys for stopping by today's video. Guys, don't forget, if you're going to buy any products from G Fuel, Scuf Gaming, DX Racer, or MetaThreads, use code EMGG at checkout for a free discount. You might as well do it. And if you do, tweet it at me and Eastern Media GG so then we can appreciate you appreciating us. And I'll see you guys all in the next video. And also, Sunday night, like I said, 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time is, I believe, the next YouTube stream right here. So, see you guys all later. Goodbye.